In this lesson, we will take a closer look at the MIPS pathway for 2008 participation in the Quality Payment Program. As previously mentioned, MIPS adjusts clinician payment based on four performance categories, including quality, cost, improvement activities, and promoting interoperability. For year two of the program, or 2018, there are weights assigned for each of the four performance categories under MIPS. Quality is worth 50 points. Cost is worth 10 points. Improvement activities is worth 15 points. And promoting interoperability is worth 25 points. You may notice changes in 2018 for the cost and quality performance categories. In the 2017 transition year, the cost performance category was worth 0 points, and the quality category was worth 60 points. Points from each performance category are added together to compute a MIPS final score, for which there are 100 possible points. The MIPS final score is then compared to the MIPS performance threshold to determine if you receive a positive, negative, or neutral payment adjustment in payment year 2020. Let's take a look at what types of clinicians are eligible to participate in MIPS for year two. The exact same types of clinicians who were able to participate during the 2017 transition year are eligible for participation in year two. MIPS eligible clinicians include physicians, physician assistants, nurse practitioners, clinical nurse specialists, and certified registered nurse anesthetists. As a reminder, physician not only refers to doctors of medicine, but also doctors of osteopathy, dentists, podiatrists, optometrists, and chiropractors. In continuing to look at who is included in MIPS for year two of the Quality Payment Program, let's look at the changes for the low volume threshold. As you may recall, for year one of the program, or 2017, the low volume threshold exclusion applied to clinicians with Medicare Part B allowable charges less than $30,000 and who saw less than 100 patients. For year two of the program in 2018, the low volume threshold has been increased, which allows for additional clinicians to be excluded from the program. CMS understands that challenges exist for certain types of practices, particularly small practices, in their ability to participate in the Quality Payment Program. So, in 2018, MIPS eligible clinicians with less than $90,000 of Medicare Physician Fee Schedule allowable charges and who see less than 200 Medicare patients a year are excluded from the program. As in 2017, voluntary reporting remains an option in 2018 for those clinicians who are exempt from MIPS. In addition to the low volume threshold exemption, there are two other basic exemption criteria that exist for MIPS in 2018 that were also present in 2017. One exemption is if the clinician is newly enrolled in Medicare during the performance period of 2018. This means he or she does not have to participate for that year. There are also exclusions for clinicians who have significant participation in an advanced alternative payment model or an advanced APM. Significant participation in an advanced APM means the clinician receives 25% of their Medicare payments or sees 20% of their Medicare patients through an advanced APM. There are special statuses that apply to certain types of MIPS eligible clinicians in year two. Meeting certain special status criteria allows for MIPS eligible clinicians to participate in MIPS with different requirements. One special status, for example, is being considered a non-patient-facing clinician. Non-patient-facing clinicians will automatically have their Advancing Care Information Performance category reweighted to zero. The 25% weight of the Advancing Care Information Performance category will be shifted to the Quality Performance category. Generally, this applies to pathologists, certain types of radiologists, anesthesiologists, and nuclear medicine clinicians. The criteria to be considered non-patient-facing for individuals and for groups has not changed for 2018 and remains the same in 2017. For individuals, non-patient-facing means the clinician has less than or equal to 100 patient-facing encounters during the 2018 performance period. For groups, It means the group has greater than 75% of its NPI's billing under the group's TIN labeled as non-patient facing during the 2018 performance period. What is new for year 2, or 2018, is criteria on how non-patient facing will apply to clinicians who choose to participate as part of a virtual group. Virtual groups with greater than 75% of their NPI's billing under the group's TIN labeled as non-patient facing during the performance period will qualify for this special status. We will discuss virtual groups in more detail later in this course. Another special status applies with the designation of being considered a small practice. Under the Quality Payment Program, whether you participate in MIPS or as part of an advanced APM, a small practice is defined as a practice with 15 or fewer MIPS-eligible clinicians. Also, the status of being located in a rural and/or health professional shortage area remains the same in 2018 as it was in 2017. That is, an individual MIPS-eligible clinician, a group, or a virtual group with multiple practices under its TIN, or TINs within a virtual group, with more than 75% of NPI's billing under the individual MIPS-eligible clinician or group's TIN, or within a virtual group, in a zip code designated as a rural area or health professional shortage area, HPSA. These special status designations under the Quality Payment Program provide provisions for certain eligible clinicians to have slightly different program requirements. For example, if you are in a practice that is in a rural area or HPSA area, your requirements for the Improvement Activities Performance category are scaled down, but with the same amount of points available towards your final score. Two other changes for 2018 that were not available during the 2017 transition year are bonuses for complex patients and the small practice bonus. The complex patient bonus of up to 5% is available for MIPS-eligible clinicians who treat complex patients. This criteria is based on a combination of the hierarchical condition categories and the number of duly eligible patients treated. The small practice bonus will add 5 points to any MIPS-eligible clinician in a small practice, as defined as 15 or fewer MIPS-eligible clinicians. The MIPS-eligible clinician or group must submit data on at least one performance category during the 2018 performance period. Let's take a quick look at the MIPS Year 2 timeline. The 2018 performance period began on January 1, 2018. Clinicians will care for patients and record data during the year. The 2018 performance period ends December 31, 2018, and all data for the performance categories must be submitted no later than March 31, 2019. CMS will then issue feedback reports during 2019, and Medicare Part B claims will begin being adjusted on January 2020. A few more notes to mention about the Year 2 2018 performance period. For the 2017 transition year, MIPS-eligible clinicians had several participation options available, known as Pick Your Pace. This allowed them to determine the extent to which they participated in MIPS during the first year. MIPS-eligible clinicians could report anywhere from less than 90 days of data up to a full year. In 2018, the performance period has been modestly increased to ensure that MIPS-eligible clinicians are prepared for future program years. For year 2, MIPS-eligible clinicians will need to report 12 months for the quality and cost performance categories, and 90 days for promoting interoperability and improvement activities performance categories. Now, let's look at the 3 ways to report to MIPS in 2018. The first two options, participating as an individual or participating as a group, are exactly the same as they were for the 2017 transition year. Individual participation is based off the unique National Provider Identifier, or NPI, and Tax Identification Number, or TIN. Participating as a group is where two or more clinicians have reassigned their billing rights over to the TIN. Group participation may also be as an alternative payment model, or APM. New for 2018 is a way of participating in MIPS as part of a virtual group. Let's take a look at more details about virtual group participation. Virtual groups are made up of clinicians or either solo practitioners or a group with 10 or less clinicians that virtually form a group for purposes of participating and reporting in the MIPS program. There are no restrictions on the types of specialties that can form a virtual group or the location of the practices. To be eligible to join or form a virtual group, you need to be a solo practitioner who exceeds the low volume threshold individually and are not a newly Medicare-enrolled eligible clinician in 2018, a qualifying APM participant or QP, or a partial QP choosing not to participate in MIPS. Alternatively, you can also be a group that has 10 or fewer MIPS eligible clinicians and exceeds the low volume threshold at the group level. Solo practitioners and groups who wish to form a virtual group must have completed the election process. Virtual group elections must occur prior to the beginning of the performance period and cannot be changed once the performance period begins. The election period was October 11th through December 31st, 2017, for the 2018 MIPS performance period. In general, policies that apply to groups in MIPS will also apply to virtual groups. Virtual groups use the same submission mechanisms as groups participating in MIPS for year two. All clinicians within a TIN are considered part of the virtual group, and data is aggregated for each performance category to be scored as a virtual group under MIPS. Lastly, let's review the data submission mechanisms for MIPS in 2018. There is no change in the data submission mechanisms available for year two of MIPS relative to the 2017 transition year. For the quality performance category, individuals may submit using a qualified clinical data registry, or QCDR, a qualified registry, the electronic health record, or EHR, or by claims. Groups, including virtual ones, may submit using the QCDR, qualified registry, EHR, or CMS web interface for groups of 25 or more. There is no submission required on behalf of the MIPS-eligible clinician for the cost performance category. CMS will calculate the cost score based on administrative claims. Improvement activities and promoting interoperability performance category data may be submitted by individuals using attestation, a QCDR, qualified registry, or EHR. Groups may submit the data by attestation, QCDR, qualified registry, EHR, or the CMS web interface for groups of 25 or more. It's important to note data must be submitted using only one submission mechanism per performance category for 2018.